Hi to everyone. I am Giridharan, working as an assistant professor in Computer Science and Engineering department. Here I am going to discuss about the topic of system software, which is an introduction to system software. Mostly what is a system software is a system software acts as an interface between a hardware and a user application. User application may be any application like Internet Explorer or Microsoft Word, like that. So mostly software will be divided into two types. So one is the main one is a system software, and then another one is a application software. The application software is a daily usage software which is visible to the user, but the system software which is hides inside the hardware, which is directly interact with hardware, but the user application cannot directly interact with hardware. So as specified in the diagram, system software interacts uses as interface between the user application and then hardware. So there are, see, these are the types, main types of system software: compiler, assembler, macroprocessor, linker, and then loader. So in compiler, the compiler is mainly used to convert the user's source code into target machine code, and then assembler, which takes an input from the compiler and then converts into the assembly level language or machine language. And then the macro processor. The macro processor is the main usage of macro processor is to execute the macros which is written inside the assembly code or then source code. So in linker, the main purpose of linker is to include the different types of files which need to be linked into the source code, which it ensures the correct execution of the user application. And then loader. The main function of loader is to load the compiler, that means resulting code from macro processor or assembler into the main memory for execution. So here now we are going to discuss about a SIC, which is a simple instruction computer. The simple instruction computer is divided into two types. One is a standard SIC, that means standard simple instruction computer, and then another one is extra expensive simple instruction computer. These two are upward compatibility. If anything which is written for the SIC can be executable in the SIC, so it is upward compatibility. And then SIC assembler. Here we are going to discuss about SIC assembler. The SIC assembler is mainly used to convert any user code into the assembly level code that needs to be executed inside the SIC computer. That means as a user application or a platform independent, but consider about SIC assembler. It is a platform oriented system. So in this, consider the simple example code jump SUB and then add AB. It is a sample code, assembly level language code, which insert as an input to the assembler, that means SIC assembler. So when we provide this example code into the SIC assembler, then it will be converted into the object code for the SIC. So the SIC can execute the user code. So here it is described as jump SUB. The SUB is a subroutine which is specified here. So during conversion there will be a problem. When execution comes here, the conversion needs to be performed. So we need the address of SUB. So but we do, which is declared after the execution line. So we need to know the address of the SUB subroutine. So for that we are going to use some other approaches called passes, which is a pass 1 and pass 2 assembler. So pass 1 assembler, the main purpose of pass 1 assembler is just it scans the input program and then stores into the symbol table. And then pass 2 assembler, in pass 2 assembler it converts the source code into the assembly level code using the intermediate code from the pass 1. That's it. Thank you.